send in any home footage of themselves or others attempting stunts. We will not open or view any submissions, so don't waste your time. The following stories are real. They contain no recreations or dramatizations. The footage was captured on video by the people involved. Do not attempt these bone-crunching, skin-splitting stunts under any circumstances. They can cause serious injury or leave you permanently scarred. Tonight on Scarred, bones get crushed and bodies get ripped. And we're counting it all down from damn that hurts.
Are you okay?
You really need a doctor.
What happened?
To the most f***ed up clip of the day. So stick around as we bring.
Hey, somebody call 911.
The pain.
That was the gnarliest thing I've ever seen, dude.
I'm Jacoby, and this is Scarred. Skateboarding will have you feeling good, loving life. And if you're like this girl, walking with a limp. This is number 5.
Hey, what's up? This is Sarah Falcon from Luling, Louisiana.
I think I broke my leg!
And this is my scar story. My friend Rochelle came over to my house and convinced me that we were gonna go skateboarding for the day, which we both kind of sucked at, and I don't think she had ever been on a skateboard in her life. We went to my friend Josh's house to go skate, because they were a lot better than I was. And so I figured if I watched them for a while, I could be better, but yeah. She was trying to convince me to go, and I was like, I want to go together.
I don't like trying new things first. I like to see what other people do with it. And then she was scared, so she was like, you go.
And everyone's laughing. They're like, y'all are girls. Y'all can't do this, whatever. And we wanted to prove them wrong.
Ready? No.
She does that. She got it, dude. Go.
I never been down a pipe before, and I was like, this is going to be awesome.
Go.
I leaned backwards instead of leaning forward. One leg stayed on the board, and the other leg just completely kept going backwards, and that's the leg that broke. The pain at first was just pure shock. The skateboard came right back and hit me in my broken leg, and that's when I knew that it was pretty bad. Ooh, yeah, that hurt.
We dropped her off, and her mom's like, what happened? And I'm like, nothing. So we would put her in her room, like, very quickly, like, and ran out the door.
But she knew. She's a mom. She knows. She knew something wasn't right. They took x-rays. My fibula broke off my tibia. That is my smaller leg bone. Then they said, oh, yeah, you broke it, and you have to have surgery. And I was like, I don't want to die. I missed out on my whole summer. That was screwy. This is my scar. They cut me open and they put a bar and 6 screws to hold them together. And if you feel my leg now, you can feel all the screws just going up on the sides. Like, it's a really weird feeling. I have a bionic leg, but it's okay. Now, ever since, my leg's not the same. I can't skateboard ever again.
I think I broke my leg.
It always hurts all the time.
Snowboarding. There's a reason most people do it on soft white powder. Whoever decided to add a long-ass metal bar to that equation was out of his f***ing mind. This is number 4.
I'm James Sievers. I'm from Steamboat Springs, Colorado. And this is my scar story. I've been snowboarding for about 10 years now. You're just out there in the mountains, you know, with your friends, having a good time. It's good stuff.
Paddock.
I was snowboarding earlier that day. Got done riding, decided I wanted to hit a handrail with my buddies, get some footage. So we were sessioning for about maybe an hour. I started out just doing some easier stuff, just gapping down the rail. I did a gap to like lip slide and a couple of like front side board slides. I didn't get enough speed really. I went for a harder trick that I'd never tried before. It's called a backside 270. Yeah. Hit the rail and I almost stuck it, so I was pretty happy. I went for it again. Same thing, so I went for it again in third try.
You all right, James?
Yeah. I probably got a concussion, but... Oh, man.
I came up too close to the rail, clipped my nose on it. Flip down the stairs and hit my head on the rail. Everything was going so fast. I just knew I was flipping. I didn't know how bad I was gonna get hurt. It was a violent looking crash, you know?
Oh man.
After I fell, I knew I was kind of hurt.
Oh, he's bleeding from the head hard.
I knew I was all right after a little bit.
So bad.
I just told myself, I'm not paralyzed, you know? I just probably got a little cut. I had an intense headache for about 10 days after that, I'd say.
Holy dude, that was gnar.
I had a pretty bad cut.
Oh, I can see it in the reflection of that camcorder.
Yeah, a couple of my buddies, they all said I should probably go get checked out.
You think it's worth stitches?
I just figured it wasn't bad enough to get stitches, so just, put a bandage on it, called it a night. Yeah, I got the scar right here on my head. It's kind of hard to see. You can see the hair's not really growing right there anymore. It's all I really ended up with, you know? I guess I got lucky.
Next time I'm gonna be wearing a helmet, for sure.
You know, if I could go back, I'd definitely be wearing a helmet, and I probably wouldn't have even hurt myself really that bad. Oh. Might even got up and tried it again.
Oh my God! Whoa. This is Scarred. There's a lot of fun ways to land on a skateboard. But landing on your face is at the bottom of that list. Just ask this kid. It's number 3.
Hi, my name is Brian Hansen from Orange County, California. And this is my scar story. All right.
Because skateboarding originated in this area, cities around here have built skate parks. And then they make it illegal to skate in the rest of the city. You're limited to something that's gonna get you away from the general public. A ditch like this is a good place to be. The night before, it was pretty nasty, like it was raining. At the time, I didn't really take that into account. I tried this trick, a backside flip. Right at the bottom of this gap, there was like a cesspool of nastiness. I would describe it as hepatitis water. So slick because of algae and mud that my feet just blew out directly behind me. And I just took all the force of me falling directly to my front teeth and my lip. I was covered literally like head to toe. Not only was it algae and sludge, it had a nice little like urban element to it. Oh, it was just utterly disgusting. After it happened, I obviously knew I was missing 3 teeth. I got up, and I knew that I was gonna need some medical attention. I was freaking out about how disgusting the water was. I was kind of scared of what kind of disease I was going to contract from that. I had some blood tests in the hospital and whatever. I think I'm okay.
Had to get my whole lip stitched across. It was kind of like a nice pitchfork scar. Split my chin, too. I'm in the process of getting new teeth. These are just temporary.
I was told that I had a fracture in my bridge. They're gonna like go in there and pour a new bone out of cement or something like that. I mean, I don't quite understand all that they're gonna do, so all I know is that it's gonna be quite a bill. At the time, no, I didn't realize like how serious this was or what kind of like physical and financial damage I had done to myself. I definitely have a new perspective now.
Welcome back to Scarred. This next guy teaches us a valuable lesson. Never lose your sense of humor, even when they're taking you out on a stretcher. It's number two.
What's up? My name is Casey Otto. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. This is my scar story.
Casey, you got knocked out.
Plan for the day was to do absolutely nothing. Plan quickly changed to, hey, let's go to the park. The park was pretty new, and they had just built this mini ramp, had a big wall in the back of it. I was like, well, this will be cool. I'm gonna foo-foo it. The hardest part of that trick is getting on top of the obstacle. A few warm-ups, get up there, you know, you don't have the speed, you jump off, you fall down. The one time that I got up there, felt like I had it.
Yeah! Hey!
As I started to pull off, I wasn't up there enough, so my brakes slipped and my tires slid. Yeah! Pretty much went from jumping on the wall to splat right to my face. My tooth, like, if you watch the video, you can see the tooth, like, fly across the ramp. Didn't knock out any of my other teeth, didn't loosen any of my other teeth. Just hit the one tooth, and it completely, like, shot it across the ramp.
Hey!
This is the first time that I've ever been knocked out. It's like being in a movie, you know? It's like one of those flashbacks. Like, you wake up and you're just like, where am I? Why am I here? What is going on?
Casey, sit down, okay? Casey, sit down.
Someone's like, oh, you did this. And you're like, oh, okay.
What happened?
He fell trying to do a foofner.
You got knocked out.
Yeah.
I'm pretty out of it, so I'm kind of in rare form.
Hey, Casey, what's your phone number?
1-900 body.
I get to the hospital, had a broken nose.
Okay, you're gonna feel a poke? Some burning.
Pretty serious concussion. Lost my tooth completely. Got stitched up and just went home. So the scar I ended up with, other than the missing tooth, which I did have replaced finally, I got a scar right across the top of my nose. Filled up pretty nicely, but it'll always be there as a reminder. I don't take the risks that I used to. At this point in my life, I don't need to knock out this tooth for the fifth time. It's a good story. If anyone asks about it, like, hey, you know, I fell on my face. You want to see the video?
Oh my God!
You are watching Scarred. Now, before we get to the end of this bloody journey, let's take a look back. Number five. Number four. Number three. Number two.
What happened?
So here it is. He may be a legend in the world of motocross, but today, he's our most f***ed up clip of the day.
What's up, I'm Brian Deegan, professional freestyle motocross rider. And I've got the most
f***ed up clip of the day.
Ah! I've been riding motocross ever since I was 8 years old. I grew up in Omaha, Nebraska, a small town. I seen that as my way to get out of Nebraska. I was more of the outcast, the punk of racing. I started a group called the Metal Militia, which was like the hardcore dudes that were all black and spikes. And it was just like this mold that I wanted a sport to be. So I got the call to do Viva La Bam. When that call comes, you come in full force. All week we were just raging, causing chaos. And it came down to this final day where I had to jump over Guar.
Shut up, humans!
Bam was skating underneath, and I had to do a backflip over everyone. Doing a backflip looks easy because the guys who do it pretty much have it mastered. But when the backflip goes wrong, it seriously goes wrong. So we start hitting the ramp and the wind is pushing us all the way to the right side of the landing. And I'm thinking, man, this is not good conditions to ride in. But, you know, the cameras are there and I'm like, you know what, I'm here. Don't be a I just remember, all right, here it goes.
Oh, man.
Get safety in there.
It happened so fast, it was crazy. I just remember under-rotating, hitting my front wheel on the landing, the handlebars jamming into my stomach.
Oh, man.
I felt like I got shot in the stomach with a shotgun.
Oh, my God.
Hey, somebody call 911.
All right, buddy?
Need somebody. Look out. You all right?
Everyone ran over, and everyone was like, oh, you all right?
Ah, it hurts.
I'm like, no, I'm not all right.
Try not to move, man.
Oh, dude, it's so gnarly.
It was, like, burning so bad, and it just progressively got worse. I just kind of looked down, and my stomach's, like, growing bigger because it's just filling with blood.
Oh, my God.
It was way more serious than I think a lot of people perceived.
Yeah, it's deep, you're right, man.
I knew I was dying for sure.
You have that one here, right?
You're deep, you're bringing an ambulance right now, man.
I woke up, tubes coming out everywhere. I talked to the doctors and I asked them what happened, and they said, you shattered your kidney, you lacerated your spleen, but one of the pieces lodged my artery, which saved my life. Without that, I would have bled out and I would have been done. I look down and I have 50 staples in my stomach and I have a zipper now. I've always seen this scar around on a lot of my buddies and I was like, I never want to get that scar. It was just so brutal looking, but that's the price you pay. When the accident happened, it changed my life. It just made me think, like, dirt bikes are so dangerous. At any time, you could die doing the sport. It was heavy, man. And that was the most f***ed up clip of the day.
Next time on Scarred.
Oh! Honestly, looked like one of my balls fell out.
Oh, my God.
You see the whole thing happening, and you're falling back, like, ugh. I just ate it bad.
So what it felt like?
Ah!